Hey, all you true believers over there in the Union, Bob Taylor coming at you from Atomic City Comics on South Street in Philadelphia from New Comic Book Wednesdays, episode number 230, a little series I do here each week just showing you all the new books that are coming out, things that I think are important, any new cons coming up, new toys hitting comic shops exclusives, new cons coming up, toy shows in the area, so on and so forth. Thanks for everybody who came out last week to the Toy Festival in Merchantville, New Jersey. It was awesome seeing you guys, and RetroCon the week before. We had a blast at both events. It was amazing. And by the way, happy National Comic Book Day. Today is National Comic Book Day, so run out and support your local comic shops. Also, what a coincidence, and maybe they geared it this way, it happens to also be Christopher Reeve's birthday today, which the late Christopher Reeves, and it's really strange to me to think that he was only going to be 57 years old. He was that young when he passed, but it was pretty dope that the two days are the same, you know what I'm saying? Or the one, they're both one day. All right, guys, let's get this started. I got a bunch of stuff to show you. I got some awesome books, nice, a killer tea, a killer toy, one pop, and let's get this started. All right. First, like I said, Leslie Minock, Sam Hain, Brace, Diana Rios. How's it going, guys? All right. Like I said in the opening, Batman Superman number 3, The Shazam Who Laughs. All right, everybody was reading The Batman Who Laughs. Well, they're running that through different books now, and this is The Shazam Who Laughs cover. Looks really dope. Dominic Novelli. Also, Web of Black Widow number 1 is out, and I'm really digging the whole hand-painted cover look. Really dope. And Star Wars Age of Resistance, Kylo Ren number 1 is out, and I'm digging the whole Vader silhouette in the background. Very cool. That is part of what Scotty Williams and I do each week. Scotty Williams and I go in and show you all the new Star Wars comics that come out for the Cantina. That's one. I actually have 3 this week. All right, you have Star Wars Fallen Order Dark Temple number 2 is out today. And you also have Star Wars Target Vader number 3 is out today. Great cover, too. All right. Now, you also have, I showed you guys the first issue of this. I really love the first issue. I'm still not feeling the whole Spock with a beard thing, but it is what it is. But this is Star Trek Discovery Aftermath number 2 is out today, guys. All right. Little Romulan warbirds hanging around over there. Is that a Klingon cruiser? Is that a Romulan? No, that's a Klingon cruiser. All right. Now, best cover of the week. All right, really digging this, and it happens to be a Marvel cover, guys. I know I show a lot of DC, but there's a lot of Marvel books in the stack this week. All right, this is Absolute Carnage tie-in, The Amazing Spider-Man, number 30. Love that cover. Sorry, somebody was calling me. All right. Love that cover, best cover of the week. All right. Now, each week, until just recently, Michael Woodard and I would show you that horror comics do still exist in the Morgue, another union group. Well, he passed that duty over to Jason Zizos, and now Jason Zizos and I are showing you the new horror books. There are actually 2 this week, okay? You have IDW first issue of Mountainhead. Now, if you're from Indiana like I am, Mountainhead's completely different. All right, and you have Red Sonja and Vampirella Meet Betty and Veronica. Awesome cover, too. Alright. I love what Boom Studios have been doing. They've been doing a lot of cool stuff lately, especially what they've been doing with the whole Power Rangers genre. Alright. This is Mighty Morphin Power Rangers number 3. Number 43. Necessary Evil. Now, I have DC Universe, number 36, Batman Beyond, guest starring The Flash. And he's like the old Flash. He's got like a beard. It looks like Aquaman in Flash's suit. But because I'm pretty sure it's Barry Allen. Like, he zipped into the future, or maybe he's still alive or something. I haven't read through it, but it's dope. Because it's in the future, it's got to be Barry Allen because he looks old. All right. But doesn't the Speed Force slow down the aging process? Always been curious about that. All right, now, lately each week I've been showing you all these reproduction books they've been doing, guys. Like, they've been redoing old books, all right? This week they have a reissue of an original Daredevil book, all right? This is Daredevil with Bullseye and Elektra, One Wins, One Dies. And I love these books because it's all the old stuff, the old ads. Look at this, look. Bubble Yum. All the stuff he used to be able to mail away for. I wish they still did this in books. It was so much fun when I was a kid. The artwork in these, look at Bullseye. The artwork in these are amazing, guys. All right, so that is your recommended read of the week, guys. All right. Next. All right, you have The Avengers number one, Loki Unleashed. Very cool book, cool cover. All right, and last but certainly not least, I always loved this book when I was a kid. I was so glad when they brought the series back. They brought it back about 10 years ago too, and then it didn't live that long and it died, but now it's back again. And this is Dial H for Hero, issue number 7 is out today. Great book, guys. All right, now I'm going to flip this around and I'm going to show you guys vintage cover of the week. This is your vintage book of the week. X-Men All New, All Different, number 95, October, 25 cents, guys. The Death of Thunderbird. That is your vintage cover of the week. All right. Now, I only have one pop to show you guys. Each week, Diana Rios show you all the new pops that come out or anything that new that came into the comic shop. And this one, I passed by last week and I didn't show you guys because I wanted to save it for this week. I've never seen this one before. It could be new, it could be old, but I've never seen it before. So this is this week's pop of the week. And this is Lord of the Rings, Sauron. Very cool piece. Nobody on the back. This was the only piece available in this wave. Very, very cool piece, guys. All right, that's it for those pops. All right, now I have an awesome toy that came in. I'm going to show you guys. I know you've got a lot of you guys are familiar with the Marvel Select line. They've been making figures for a lot of years, and I came across, I was in another comic shop recently in Port Richmond that I will not name, in case he's watching this, because he likes to break my stones because my picture's always backwards. But he had some Marvel Select style Bruce Lee figures. Well, I didn't realize that they were making more and more different figures that weren't necessarily Marvel. Well, we got one in that I'm really digging, and this is it's a Select. It's not a Marvel Select, it's just a Select, just like the Bruce Lee was. But this is the John Wick Select figure, guys. Very, very cool. Comes with a lot of weapons, a coin, even his little dog that nobody's supposed to mess with. Very, very cool. Turn that around. Elazar, Dennis, what's up? Very, very cool piece, guys. Really liking this. And he's all beat up. Digging it. All right. Now, last but certainly not least, no new Comic Book Wednesdays would be complete without a Tiny Nerd Tea. All right, and we have an awesome one this week. And it just happens to remind me that this gentleman is almost always at New York Comic Con. Next week's video will be coming to you from New York Comic Con, the floor setup of the day of the setup, Wednesday, before the show even opens. All right, so look forward to that. I'll be out in New York next week for New York Comic Con. There'll be a ton of pictures, a ton of videos. My girl's coming with me. It's going to be a blast, guys. But this is your Tiny Nerd Tea of the week. Evil Dead Boomstick, dude. Very, very, very cool. All right, guys. Now, like I said, don't forget to check me out next week from New York Comic Con. There'll be tons of pics and videos, and this video, number 231, will be broadcast from New York Comic Con next week. All right, and that about wraps it up for this episode of New Comic Book Wednesdays. Check us back here next week, same Bob time, same Bob channel, for episode number 231 of New Comic Book Wednesdays, coming at you from New York Comic Con. And as always, don't forget, not only your toys, but your comics are always safe here. Always have a home here in the Union. I'm Bob Taylor. That's my bit. Peace, love, toys, and comics. I am out, homies. Love yous all. See yous next week.